All right, everyone, welcome back to another One Piece Bounty Rush video. My name is D3 here today. We are going to be doing some gameplay with the new Nami. So if you guys enjoy today's video, hit that subscribe if you are new for more content. Without further ado, let's go ahead and get into it. All right, let's get into our first game. Okay, so, the double waifu matchup over there. I see you. I see you, my boy, a man of culture over there. All right, so this is fine. We've got a couple of greens. There's only one red in this match. Okay, that's good for my greens that are on my team, but not so great for me. Now, Nami's also good in a couple of different roles. She's able to be a capable damaging unit, but she also is obviously her primary role is as a runner because that's what she is, right? She has got the fastest movement among like characters being typing and stuff like that, moving characters, running characters, excuse me, to be more specific. That's not just her, though. It's all runners. And then also capture speed. So, again, that is her primary role, but there will be times where I kind of stall a little bit just to try to help out as far as, like, doing attacks are concerned. I'm going to tell them to try to guard the treasure. Those two Zoros, man, y'all got to do it. We got two defenders. Go guard the treasure. That was a misclick, but that's fine. I'm still the fastest one out here. Although, I don't think I'm going to go for it, though, because the stupid Sanji came. And Boa, by extension. Got to stay out of her range. Boa's really annoying if you get in her range. There's a lot of them over here. My goodness. They're all here. Everybody's right here. It's really congested. Okay. Sanji. I need to save my evade for Sanji. Get away from me. Thank you. Thank you. All right. Hopefully I can get some crits and stuff. That'd be really helpful. Ooh, got out of there just in time. Oh my goodness. Wow, Boa, that's a lot of damage. Get away! Get away! Great job there, Nami, great job. And we're gonna take the fifth treasure here. So I can't defend A by myself. So they're gonna go ahead and get that, of course. I can't do anything about that. But I do hope these guys start charging the treasure, man. Please start charging treasure. Charge the treasure, please. Okay, that was bad. That was a bad idea, but that's fine. Of course he stole that when I was gonna go for it. Okay. Yeah, see, like, doing 5K, 6K, those are good hits, man. It's not a ton of damage, but those are a good couple of hits. Let me get away from them, because they're just going to do too much. And this is pretty much how I like to play runners. I just kind of freelance. Oh, wow. I got hit, and I didn't even see that one coming. The Boa hit me from way afar. I did not see that. You guys, like, literally are not charging the treasure like I've asked many times, but okay. We need a charge treasure, actual quote, not guard, because guard makes me think that people think that I just want them to kind of play around the treasure, which is not exactly the case. Great job. I'll go over here. No. Go away. I got this. That's fine. I'll let her take it. I said I had it, man. Dang. I had it. I was fine. Ah, crap. That one's over there. I really want that. I'm going to go get it really quick. And come over here to defend the middle. Yeah, we got this one. That was a good game. That was a good game. Definitely a good game. That's definitely a good game. The Nami KO was really good. The double KO, man. So that's awesome. We'll be right back for another match here in just a moment, guys. Okay, so we're playing in a different location this time, and this one there's a lot of reds, so that's good, and only one green. Okay, see, things like that are important for Nami because she's able to, I believe she takes reduced damage around enemy treasure. It's one of those two. I didn't ever really go over that in the beginning. But yeah, like that type of stuff regardless is important for her because she's not going to be in a position where she takes so much damage. Unless it's from like obviously like a blue unit that can hit really hard like the 2 years later Luffy. All right, let's do this. I am the, well, not the fastest this time around. Speaking of 2 years later Luffy, I got two on my team. The double Zoros are going to go down the middle probably. I think I'm going to try to go for B here. Yeah, I'm going to go for B because I'm going to let the – I imagine the Zoros are both rushing to the middle. It looks like it if you look at the map. They're both equal speed, so those got to be both Zoros. So I'll try to take these two bottom ones if possible. No, this one's going to get defended here really quick. Crocodile, huh? Okay. That's fine. I went a little bit too soon there, but it didn't wind up hitting me, so that's fine. Let me hit him a couple more times here. Got a little bit more damage on the crocodile. Oh, my crocodile came to help. Good. Nice. Okay. Together, we're going to be able to obviously make short work of this guy. So while he's taking care of that, I'll just kind of go over here. Okay. Wow, they're all over here. That's funny. All right. Crap, I went a little too soon. No. Thank you for bailing me out a little bit there. Not going to lie. I went just a split second too soon there. Yeah, I have to be careful with Mihawks. I forget how much damage he does neutral. He does a lot of damage neutral. We have all the treasures pretty much right now that are back here. I'd like for us to guard treasure, man. It's almost like, please stop overextending. Please stop. We don't need to go for five. We just need to win. This should hit a couple of them. Okay. I said please stop overextending, and I'm doing it. At least I got a couple good hits in, though. Okay. All right. So far, I've been able to help, though. Oh, got him at the last second. All right. I keep wasting that move. Every time I use it, it doesn't hit anybody. I just waste it. Ooh, team boost. Thank you. Oh, I thought I was going to get him before he could hit me with that. I shouldn't have went for the gamble. Oh, man, that might cost us the match because we lost two guys in the middle. Go, Zoro. Go. Oh, crap, they're coming over here. That's bad. Wow, my gamble was going to cost us the match. That's fine. You can take it. There we go. Come on. There we go. Okay, well, we captured another one anyway. I really like using the Luffy for that elephant gun at the very end. You have to delay it. Because the reason why I wait for them to capture the treasure, if it's close like that anyway, is because I let them do it most of the time because it pretty much one-shots. And on top of that, they'll just dodge away or whatever and then turn into sometimes a bigger problem. And I also realized that I had an ally that was near me that could help me out with capturing that. So there we go. I kind of want to go back and review Nami a little bit just because I didn't really do that. But ultimately, though, she's quite good and she's quite powerful, right? The second guy on my team had 9 KOs. Luffy was putting in work. Yeah, so the way I like to run with runners, sometimes I get 5-6 captures in a game, but a lot of times with Nami, I like to kind of freelance and sometimes help out with attacking. And a lot of times I'm better with the whole, the shot in every direction. Skill one? A lot of times I'm better with that. But in this one, I wasn't so good. Aside from that double KO, though. All right, so let's go over a very brief breakdown of Nami here. So her water gun, it's just a long-range attack. Skill power is 546, and then cooldown is 39. I do run skill one cooldown set. So I try to get that as much as I can. The high kick, I'm kind of jaded on. Like it's really fast. I don't like that it does a fixed amount of damage per se. I mean, I guess it's probably better for less stars on Nami, like people that don't have her to the level that I do. But for me, it feels kind of underwhelming at times. But the knockback is the most important thing. It does a knockback effect, and then there's a 50% probability to confuse them for 5 seconds. So that's how you read this 4-step-1 broken English stuff they got going on. So it has its viability, man. It's good, and it's very quick, but it's a very short range. Like, as you saw at the end there, Well, to be fair, I was just a split second off. I would have got him and knocked him back. Like, there was a sequence towards, like, the last, like, 40 seconds of the last match where I think I knocked two enemies flying towards the barrels and stuff like that. So, team boost is speed boost. That's good for us, right? It allows for the team to just move faster. Her character trait is when receiving damage, she has a 3% chance to inflict stun for a short period of time. It's whatever. I mean, it's cool if it pops off. Most cases it won't, but it's cool if it does. Trey 1, when your strength is more than 70%, boost capture speed by 50%. So she's a very, especially early in the game where you have high strength, she's a very good capture unit. Like, again, that's her primary role anyway. She's a runner. That's what they are meant to do, right? When in the area around your capture treasure, boosts the cooldown reduction speed of skill 2. So there are times where it's beneficial to hang out around your own treasure because the cooldown speed of skill 2 goes very, very high, right? The high kick already has a shorter cooldown anyway, at 21 seconds anyway. And then also, we'll go ahead and take a look at some other stuff she does here. So the trait 2 at the bottom, when using skill run, you recover 10% of your HP. This is why sometimes I kind of just use that skill recklessly. Now, there was only a couple matches here, so there wasn't the best examples of it. Generally, I like to use it when there's a just congested area of enemies, because everybody's trying to advance or whatever. And it's good to get a hit in or two on some of them. Not all of them, but some of them. The closer you are, the more likely you are to hit, right? But it heals you anyway. So, like, for a character like her, who is predicated on running, right, it's good to have that longevity with you. Also, for the second part of trait 2, when your allies are not near the treasure area where you're at, reduce damage received. So if you were trying to make the distance, this is why I said she's got some longevity. She's got some versatility to her. Whenever you're trying to make that push, right, and if your allies are not around you, she has a skill that can heal her, and she also takes reduced damage, right? And then if she happens to be higher on strength, she's able to capture quicker, things of that nature. So she's got a very conducive kit, and I really do enjoy her. I think that they did a good job with this unit. So anyways, her attack also is almost 1,500 if you round up, so she's pretty powerful, man. Thank you all for tuning in. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Hit that thumbs up if you did, and I'll catch all of you guys in the next one.